Today I'm going to show you how to roll over covered call options for the best possible cash flow and profit, whether you're rolling them up, down, they're deep in the money, or rolling them out in time. By the time this video is through, you will know the best way to roll your covered call options. I'm Randy Perez. I'm a 21 plus year stock and option trader, as well as real estate investor. If you're already a member of our community, thank you for setting aside a part of your day to be here. If you're not already a member of this community, go ahead and click the subscribe button and bell notification. You will be joining a community of traders and investors that are helping each other become more knowledgeable and profitable. Selling covered call options is one of my favorite ways to generate cash flow every month in my trading account. Last month, we generated over $9,600 in cash, mainly from selling options. I'm excited to share with you the strategies I use to roll my covered call options, whether they are out of the money, at the money, or even deep in the money. How do you handle your covered call positions? If they go in the money, do you let your stock be called away from you, or do you try and roll the position? In the comments below, let me know what your preferred technique is when it comes to your covered call options. And stay tuned in until the end of this video where I will share with you a technique that I use when rolling deep in the money covered call options that yields incredible returns. I'm going to share with you an actual trade I did a few weeks ago using this exact strategy. As investors, we obviously want to generate the absolute best return and or cash flow while protecting our precious capital. Selling call options against stock you own is one of the best ways that you can do that. Generally, the stocks that I sell puts on and allow to be assigned to me so I can begin selling covered call options against them are dividend stocks. By selling covered call options on dividend stocks, we get bonus cash flow because we not only receive the covered call option premium, but we also collect those sweet dividends. Let me show you how to handle the four different scenarios that covered call option traders face at expiration time. We'll discuss how to handle rolling down covered calls, rolling covered calls when they are out of the money, at the money, and deep in the money. For each of these scenarios, I'm going to share with you an actual trade I made using that technique over the past month or so. I'm going to talk you through the thought process, which will enable you to understand a strategy you can use to maximize your cash flow and profit when you roll your covered call options. Let's first look at how to handle rolling down covered calls on stocks that are declining. One such position I have that's been declining is in ExxonMobil, ticker symbol XOM. Here you see my position on the screen. 400 shares of ExxonMobil were put into our account from some put options that we've been selling at the $75 strike price. Since that time, ExxonMobil has been continually moving lower. Now, I do not have a lot of energy-based positions in my portfolio, so I've decided that this is a position that I'm going to hold on to, even though overall it's really down. As such, I've been not only collecting those dividends, but I've also been selling call options against those 400 shares I own. As you can see here, the chart really doesn't look all that promising right now. It looks as though ExxonMobil may continue to decline or just hang out where it's at for a while. I prefer to sell my call options at strong resistance. Typically, I try to couple that with moving averages. The longer the time frame moving average, the better. Previously, I had sold several call options around the 200 moving average on the daily chart, which is around $50 per share. But there just is not enough premium right now on those $50 options, even if I go out in time, to generate any kind of decent return. So next, I looked at the closest moving average, which is the 50 moving average here on the daily chart, or the green line. This past Friday was option expiration Friday here in August. I was hoping that ExxonMobil would jump up a little bit to be able to roll the August short call options for a decent profit, but it just didn't happen. So on Friday, I let the $52.50 strike call options expire worthless and decided that within the next week or so, I would look for an opportunity to sell some call options as soon as I saw a bump in price. After a little bump in price, I sold some call options today. I've been rolling these call options down as the stock price continues to decline, but I'm trying to place them at strike prices that if the stock jumps, it should hit some resistance. That would give me a chance to buy to close the current short call option and sell to open a new call option at a higher strike price. undoubtedly I have to roll that call option out to be able to roll it for a credit. So this is a position that I'm watching a little bit closer than most of the other positions I have. If you'd like a little more information on exactly how I pick the strike price that I sell covered call and put options at, check out the two videos in the link above in the description below on how to trade using technical analysis and multiple time frame support and resistance. One nice thing about trading options is that you really don't have to watch these positions all that closely. Several times a week is usually sufficient. The week or two before option expiration, Friday is always busier, but since that just passed last week, the next couple weeks should be pretty slow. The ExxonMobil position, I'll peek at it several times a week just to make sure something crazy hasn't happened with OPEC or something like that, which would trigger me to go ahead and adjust that short call position. When a stock is moving down, you have two choices. You can either get out of the position or consider rolling your covered call strike options down while trying to place them above resistance. Here on the screen, you see the 50 moving average as well as some of the other previous highs around the $45 strike price. With that knowledge, I sold to open the $45 October call options and received 56 cents per share. When you add in the quarterly dividend of 87 cents per share, our cash on cash returns position is right at 10% based on the $75 strike price that the stock was put into our account at. Now our call spaces is a good bit less than that, but this just goes to show you that you can still make nice cash on cash returns even on a declining stock. We expect ExxonMobil at some point to come back, but until then, we're just gonna continue collecting that dividend and selling those call options against the position that we have. Let's now look at how to roll covered calls forward when they're out of the money and in a stable or appreciating stock. First, let's look at a trade we made last week, the third Friday of the month, our favorite week of the month because it's monthly options expiration week. Here you see our current position in Bank of Ozarks, ticker symbol OZK. Back in February this year, we were assigned 400 shares of Bank of Ozarks on some puts that we've been selling since the end of last year. We were assigned the shares at $30 per share. Since that time, we've been selling covered call options against this position. Back in May, we had sold the August $25 covered call options against our 400 shares. As we neared option expiration on the third Friday of August, you can see here on the chart, there between the 5th and the 18th, Bank of Ozarks was actually trading above our short covered call strike price of $25. If you watch my channel, you know that I like to put my roll orders out there a couple weeks before option expiration day. You just never know what orders might get hit at some awesome return. Since the price action of the chart seemed positive, I was actually trying to buy to close those August $25 call options and sell to open the 30 call option for a nice credit. The order did not get hit. So on August 21st, option expiration day, with the stock trading around $23, I realized that our stock was not going to be called away from us. So I canceled the roll order and let the August 21st $25 call option expire worthless. I then sold the September 3rd Friday of the month $25 call option and received 35 cents per share for it. Here you can see the execution of our order. We're actually paid a penny by Interactive Brokers to do this trade because they defined us as a market maker. So that makes you a little bit happier, right? No commission option trading, what could be better? What kind of return does this produce for us? If we were able to get a similar amount, 35 cents per share per month for the next 12 months, then we would be able to collect $4.20 per share on this stock. If you divide that by the price the stock was put into our account, $30, then the annualized return is 14%. Pretty decent on a good, solid, dividend-paying bank stock, right? But now let's add in the dividend that we're receiving. Currently, the dividend is just over 27 cents per quarter. So in all, we would expect to collect $5.29 per year per share on this stock. Our basis is $30 per share. That equates to a 17.6% annualized return. I'm very happy with that. It's a nice return on a bank that I like owning. I've mentioned many times on this channel that when you're selling put or covered call options, a couple weeks before expiration, go ahead and run some numbers and see what kind of return you'd be happy to get on that position. Put your order out there, good till close, and just see what happens. A good percent of the time, my orders get hit for some awesome returns. The stock may move just right for a very brief period of time, maybe even just a few minutes, and your order gets filled and then it moves away from you. If you don't have an order sitting out there, then you would never be able to take advantage of the fluctuations in the market. It didn't happen for us on this trade, but it is a nice example of how I like to handle call options where the covered call that I sold that is expiring is out of the money on a stable stock like Bank of Ozark. Let's now take a look at how to handle situations where the covered call option you sold is at the money around option expiration day. Here you see my current position in Lazar, ticker symbol LAZ. Let's focus on the covered call portion of my position here. I was assigned 400 shares of Lazard several months ago in May at the $40 per share price. The stock price has come down some, but that doesn't really bother me any. I really like the company and I'd like to own it for the long term if possible. But I want to do better than just the current 6% dividend. So we've been selling covered calls against our position here. And as you can see here on the hourly chart, the difference in this position and the last one in Bank of Ozarks is that the short call that we had sold in Lazard that expired on the third Friday of August at $31 strike price was at the money on option expiration day. I did not want to risk the stock being called away from me, so I had a roll order sitting out there to buy to close the $31 strike call option and sell to open the third Friday of September $32 call option. The reason I rolled that short strike price up is because I really feel like Lazard may continue to increase in price. We really don't know what's going to happen with it, but my gut tells me that there's a good chance that it could increase in price, and this is a stock that I want to own for the long term if it's possible. Here you see the trade that we did. We were able to buy to close the August 21st $31 call option for 3 cents and simultaneously sold to open the September 18th $30 call option for 65 cents. That means we pocketed the difference, or 62 cents per share. If we are able to do a similar trade every month for the next 11 months, then we would expect to pocket about $7.44 per share. That's good enough for an 18.6% annualized return. Remember, because we like trading dividend stocks, we're also collecting a dividend on this company. As a matter of fact, as you can see on the screen, we just collected the dividends for Lazard on the same date, August 21st. It paid us $188 for our 400 shares. When you add in that dividend, if we were able to do a similar trade here at 62 cents per share every month for the next 11 months, we'll be able to pocket $9.32 per share for the year. When you divide that by our $40 cost per share, that gives us a 23.3% annualized return. Now, I don't expect to be able to get that type of option premium every month, but it just shows you the power of using a covered call option strategy. We were able to roll our strike price up by a dollar and still get a 23% annualized return. That's awesome. The lesson here is that if you think your stock has the potential to increase in price and you don't want it to be called away from you, go ahead and put an order out there to roll your option up. And of course, we always want to try and do that for a credit. Next, we're going to talk through the process of rolling deep in the money covered calls. But if you're liking the video, why don't you do me a favor and tap the thumbs up button? It helps support the channel and it means a lot to me. And stay tuned in until the end because I'm going to share with you a technique you can use when rolling deep in the money covered calls to generate awesome returns while rolling your covered call strike price up and still enabling you to put a wad of cash into your pocket just like I did on the trade I'm going to show you in just a moment. Let's now talk about rolling deep in the money covered call options. If you've been trading covered calls for any amount of time, at some point, a stock is probably going to surprise you and move way past the short strike price call option that you sold. It's actually probably a good thing because it means you picked a stock that's performing well. But for a covered call option trader, if you're hoping to keep the stock, it isn't really what we want to have happen. So how do we handle this scenario? Of course, if you're fine having the stock called away from you, you can just let that happen. Personally, if I've been assigned a stock, I would like to try my best to keep it. I generally try to trade in stocks that continue to increase their dividend at a nice pace, and so I like to benefit from that increasing dividend every year if possible. I'm going to show you two scenarios here. The first one is in FedEx, ticker symbol FDX. As you can see here on the screen, in my portfolio tab for FedEx, the 100 shares of FedEx have been put into my account because of a put options I've been selling. This happened almost a year ago in last October, where the white circle is on the far left of the chart. It was put into my account at $160 per share. For a while, FedEx cooperated with us as it traded virtually sideways for about 5 months. Then all of a sudden, back in March, like a lot of stocks, it crashed down to $90 per share. Since then, it's been gaining ground until in July, it decided to take off like a rocket. If possible, I'd really like to hang on to FedEx. I like the company, and with e-commerce really taking off, I think it's a company that will do well in the future. I'd been selling the $40 call options for several months back in April, May, and June, but after the stock jumped way up in July, I wanted to try and benefit from some of that move and also try to prevent the stock from being called away from me. Notice on the screen the trade that I did. On July 7th, we bought to close the $140 covered call option that was expiring on the 17th. It cost us $18.83 per share to buy it back. Notice what we did next. We had to go out 3 months to the third Friday of October, but we were able to sell the October $145 strike call option for $20.86. Here's what we've accomplished. We've rolled our strike price up $5 and still pocketed $2.03 per share. The reason we were able to do this is because we went out 3 months in time. This is one way I like to handle covered call positions that are deep in the money. I still would ideally like to continue owning the stock and collecting the dividend, and one way to try and help us do this is by going out in time to sell the next call option. Use the credit from selling that new higher strike price call option to buy back the call option that's expiring in the current month. Roll the strike price up and still pocket some cash. We still have about a month and a half or so before this option expires, so we'll just see how it goes. The stock is going ex-dividend next week, so there's always a possibility that it's called away from us before that happens. But either way, I'm glad we rolled this option up $5 and were able to pocket nice cash when we did that. At the beginning of this video, I told you I was going to share with you a technique I use when rolling deep in the money covered call options that yields incredible returns. I also told you that I would share with you a trade I did a couple weeks ago using that exact strategy. Let me show you this trade, tell you why I did this trade, and how you can do something similar on a trade like this in your covered call positions that have gone deep in the money on you. The trade I want to share with you is in Genuine Parts Company, ticker symbol GPC. Notice here on the screen our current position. 100 shares of Genuine Parts Company were put into my account back in May. Since then, I've been selling covered call options against my 100 shares. Since I'm not at a full position, I've also been selling a put option contract on GPC. If you notice here on the daily chart, it looks as though Genuine Parts is in a nice uptrend. I really like this company. I really like to own it for the long term. However, after reporting solid earnings, the $82.50 strike covered call option I sold went deep in the money. I also knew that the ex-dividend date was coming up in a couple weeks, so the chance of the stock being called away from me if there wasn't much time premium left in that covered call option was pretty high. In order to avoid the stock from being called away from me, so I can continue collecting dividends, benefit from the upward movement of the stock, and still put nice cash in my pocket, I decided I needed to roll the covered call strike price up $5. Notice on the screen that first we bought to close the covered call and put option that were expiring on the third Friday of August. We had to pay $12.41 for the $82.50 call option and 17 cents to close out the $82.50 put option. We then had to go out 3 months to November 20th, but we were able to roll our covered call strike price up $5 to 87.50. At the same time, we rolled our short put option up to $90. We were able to walk away with a credit of $2.35 per share. If you take that $2.35 per share plus the $5 we were able to roll our strike price up, that gives us $7.35. If you annualize that return using the $90 strike put option as well as our cost basis in the stock of $90, that gives us a 16.3% annualized cash on cash return. But remember, because we're trading dividend stocks, we also get the benefit from the dividend, which is currently 79 cents per quarter on the 100 shares that we already own. So overall, our annualized return is just over 18%. The lesson here is that if you are not at a full position in a stock that you own, sell put options to help generate enough cash to move your strike price up on your call option if you don't want the stock called away from you. If you couple that selling put options with selling out in time, you can still generate awesome returns, keep your stock, and continue collecting dividends and option premium on that stock. I love this technique. It's like a secret weapon that only us option sellers can use to hold on to awesome stocks and still generate tremendous returns. If you'd like some more information on our exact trades, consider the benefits of becoming a patron in the description, the link below. You'll be receiving some awesome information that you can use to become a better, more profitable option trader, all while supporting this channel. And I'd like to give a quick shout out and big thank you to our current Patreon members. Thank you for your support. I greatly appreciate it. Check out the videos in the link above and the description below where I share with you my top secrets and tips on how to trade options like a pro. Until next time, happy investing, and we'll see you again soon.